What do David Copperfield and theatres have in common? Given where we all are today, you might be thinking showmanship, performance, or maybe just bad jokes. This last one might actually be true, but no. I'm talking about magic. I'm talking about operating theatres. Now, I'm actually not a magician. I'm a plastic surgeon, a profession built on precision and perfect science. But what we found is that when you mix perfect science together with creativity and innovative thoughts of those around you, that's when things get better. That's when the magic happens. Not so long ago, people would come to a theatre much like this one to watch operations happening. Can you believe this? Come to a theatre like this to watch operations. As a surgeon, I could actually advertise the operations I was going to perform in the local newspapers to try and encourage an extra few ticket sales. And if we sold out, we'd simply cancel the show until we found a larger venue. And now just imagine, if I was a good surgeon and the patient made it through the operation, the audience might even give me a round of applause. What an absurd time it must have been. A few hundred years ago, the surgeon was the star and the patient, well, you know, just a mere little incidental extra on the stage. It was very much a one-man show. I'm so pleased that much has changed since then. Working in teams has been hugely beneficial, not just for the patient, but even for us as professionals. For those of you that have never been to one, and perhaps even for those of you that have, operating theatres can be a daunting, sometimes intimidating place. Each member of the team has an important job to do, and a team that works well can be the difference between life and death. Each team member has possibly gone through years and years of studying, not to mention more on-the-job training than you can imagine. But what happens when we go beyond our essential training? What happens when we start using our life experiences as people, as human beings, to complement those technical skills? Let me remind you, magic happens. I'd like to tell you about Alan. He's not a magician either, by the way. Alan is one of our theatre support workers. He's been quietly, unassumingly, been working hard with me for about 3 months. Alan had realised for my major breast reconstruction cases, I use about 40 stitches. He'd also realised that these stitches are kept outside of theatre and that it takes about a minute and a half to collect. Alan calculated that this added an extra hour to every surgery. Alan, being Alan, simply started keeping the stitches in his top pocket, and in doing so has saved us hours of surgery time. Now, shortly after Alan's light bulb moment, we saw it again with Sarah, a student. Sarah came to the operating theatre, and she was overwhelmed with the amount of equipment we have around the operating table. We have the bed in the middle, together with a microscope, anesthetic machine, surgical trays, and all this other surgical paraphernalia. All of this means that it's difficult for multiple surgeons to operate on the patient simultaneously. Sarah went home that evening. She stayed up all night. She came back the next day with this piece of paper she'd drawn, which was a blueprint of how we could better arrange all the theatre equipment. What this meant is that multiple surgeons could operate on different parts of the patient's body at the same time safely. Absolute magic. Now, I'd actually like to tell you a little about myself. I've been fortunate enough to have grown up in an environment in which my parents have wanted me to freely express my ideas and opinions without ever fearing being judged or ridiculed. I saw firsthand the benefits that this brought to my own life. And I was keen to create that same safe nurturing environment for all that work within my theatre team. I wanted to make sure that everyone's voices were not just heard, but acted upon. One of the best things about doing this is the domino effect that follows. People start talking, people start sharing ideas, and what happens? Innovations happen. I'd like to tell you about Mary. Mary is a lady in her 40s. She's a successful career woman. She is adored by her family and friends. She led a healthy and happy life until sadly one day Mary discovered a lump in her breast. Mary had breast cancer, a devastating blow for her and everyone around her. Mary required surgery to cut out the breast cancer, some of the lymph nodes, followed by an aggressive course of chemotherapy and radiotherapy too. She recovered, got back to her life. Sadly though, 11 years later, the cancer did come back with a vengeance. It spread to her rib cage, breastbone, and was even coming through the skin. Despite the pain, she remained optimistic. We couldn't offer Mary any further radiotherapy, so we tried a new targeted anti-cancer treatment. It helped her symptoms, but it wasn't a cure. At this stage, most centres would not have offered Mary any further treatment. But Mary was scared. She'd actually lost her sister to breast cancer a few years earlier that had spread to her brain. We were as desperate as Mary to try and make her well again. And the only option was high-risk surgery. The surgery would involve cutting out the affected skin, underlying muscle, breastbone and ribs. I typically then rebuild this using bone cement, the same cement we use to fix hips and knees. It's soft and moldable to start before it sets hard. I literally shape it by hand, patting, a little like pizza dough. The whole thing is quite rough and ready, really. There must be a better way. And then, a magical idea. I started talking to my team about my children. They loved playing with Play-Doh. They would make animals, shapes, not to mention a huge mess in the kitchen, of course. They used these Play-Doh molds all the time. And these Play-Doh molds then sparked an idea for our prosthetics team. These team members are experts at making artificial eyes, ears, fingers, noses, and just about anything. And they suggested that we might be able to print Mary's rib cage in 3D based on her CT scans. Our thoracic surgeons then jumped in to say, we could actually mark out the cancer on those 3D prints. And there it was. Magic. This is the world's first 3D printed chest wall mold, thanks to a melting pot of magical ideas. These are the ribs. This is the cancer that required cutting out and reconstructing. This would not have been possible without the collaborative efforts of the University Hospitals of Leicester's plastic surgery team, thoracics team, prosthetics team, and not to forget those inspiring children playing with Play-Doh. Mary has since gone on to make a full recovery, and she is forever grateful that our team took a chance on her. Teamwork is the magic that allows ordinary individuals to achieve extraordinary results. I am only one of 1.3 million individuals that makes up our wonderful National Health Service. We each bring with us a very different set of skills, talents, and interests. Each and every one of us sitting in the audience today is able to go back to our own workplaces we're able to go back to our offices, our clinics, perhaps even our operating theatres to start fostering such an environment. Experts might call what I've described today as optimising outcomes. Some might even describe it as quality improvement. But while David Copperfield created illusions, together, collectively, we create the magic of humanity. Thank you.